Assalamu alaikum students, your instructor Abdul Rafi here. So moving forward, continuing on concept number 2, we have now discussed in statistics 2, chapter number 4, sampling and estimation. We already have the information about the sample, how do you find the random sample, what ways to do, calculator generated, and all those basic theory and understanding. Now there comes the important part, that how will you find the concept number 2 talks about how will you find the sample mean x bar, that how will you find the mean x bar of it, and what about the concept of central limit theorem. We are going to talk about this in the concept number 2. So students need to understand the first important thing, that there are two important rules to this concept number 2. The first thing is, the first important rule of concept number 2 is that if x is following a normal distribution, okay, we need to understand. So x is a variable, x is following a normal distribution. X can be any observation, it can be any independent data. X is following a normal distribution. We already know from statistics 1 or from our basic concepts that we have mean and we have variance. Mean comma variance, we have the mean and variance. Then you can say if x follows a normal distribution, then x bar, which is basically the sample mean, okay, x bar is what, students? The sample mean. The sample mean will also follow a normal distribution, where we have to understand that the mean will remain the same, sir. The mean will remain the same. It's just that the variance will be divided by the sample size, okay? Variance will be divided by the sample size, where n is basically called the sample size, okay students? So n is equals to the sample size that we have. This is basically how you will find out the sample mean and questions related to that. This is one of the pointers in this case of concept number 2. If the x is already, I'll repeat my point students, we need to understand that if x is already following a normal distribution, then x bar will also follow a normal distribution. What is, sir, x bar? Sir, x bar is basically the sample mean, in which we have sample mean and sample variance. X bar will also follows. Again, this is sampling chapter only. We haven't reached the estimation part yet. It is x bar follows normal distribution, lecture number 2, where mean is there and variance will be divided by the sample size, that is n, where n is equals to sample size. But the important thing is that what to do when you don't have the normal distribution, okay? We need to understand that the concept number 2 will come in, that when x is not normally distributed, okay, follow carefully. That is what we need to understand in this lecture, followed by an example of the past paper question as well. We are going to do a past paper question followed by this as well. So students need to understand, if x is not normally distributed, okay students, sir, let's say that if x is not normally distributed, so when x is not normally distributed, for example, it is something else, it is the other discrete random variable, it is other random variable, okay, when x is not normally distributed, but you can say when the sample, but n is large, okay, so we can say that n is large means, okay, follow very carefully, what is n, sir? N is the sample size. So you can estimate if n is greater than equals to 30, we can say that if n is greater than equals to 30, if x is not normally distributed, and you also have the mean and variance, you have the mean, sir, you have the mean available, and you have the variance available as well, okay, you have mean and variance available, x is not normally distributed, n is large, we need to understand the central limit theorem will come into existence, okay students, sir, the central limit theorem will come in when x does not follow normal distribution. I'll repeat my point students, the examiner always tests you on your conceptual understanding as well. All only remember, the central limit theorem will only come when x is not following a normal distribution and n is large, which means that n should be greater than equals to 30, where n means the sample size. So in simple meaning, where you have the mean available, if you have mean available and if you have variance available as well, and your n, the sample size, is larger than 30, if your sample size n is larger than 30, then we need to understand that the central limit theorem will help us, sir. Central limit theorem will say that x bar follows a normal distribution. X bar will follow normal distribution, again, where the mean is this and variance will be divided by the variance will become variance divided by the sample size approximately, provided that n is sufficiently large. Why we are doing this? You have one simple reason to write it down, that we are doing this because the larger the sample size, I'll write it down, the larger the sample size, the better the approximation is. The larger the sample size, the larger the sample size, the better approximation it is. So it is important that n should be large, sufficiently large, so that x can follow, x bar can follow the normal distribution, where x was not normally distributed, okay? Where x was not normally distributed. So central limit theorem will help us to, central limit theorem, the better the approximation. The central limit theorem will come in concept number two, okay students? So I'll make an arrow as well for students to understand that this central limit theorem comes in this case, okay? Students need to understand central limit theorem comes in this case only. If the question is already normally distributed now, if the question is already normal distribution, then you don't need to apply this concept, okay? Then central limit theorem will not be there, because then already x bar follows the normal distribution, okay? Then already x bar follows a normal distribution. So here we go, this is the concept. And now we'll solve an example past paper question to apply this as well, how this will come into existence with the topical past paper questions. So let's get started, students. We have on page number 23, we have a February-March 2018 question. Follow carefully. Let me write down the important points first. This is 2018, February-March. So this is not very recent and not very old as well. Conceptually, very good. So this is based on concept number two, understanding, students. If you need to learn concept number two, you can watch this. This is about the sample mean and the sample mean and the x bar, okay? Sample mean x bar with the central limit theorem as well, okay? So it's concept of central limit theorem, when it will come, because a lot of time examiner will ask, should we apply central limit theorem or not? A lot of questions will be asking, okay, should you apply central limit theorem or not? So you have to think about it and remember the two cases. If x is already normal distribution, then there is no need. In summary, if x is already normal distribution, then there is no need. But if n sample size is large and you can convert it, you have the mean and variance available, so x bar can follow normal distribution due to the concept of central limit theorem. So let's talk about this question example, students. We have that x is basically a random variable. Here we can see, students, that x is a random variable. Sir, the mean is available, the standard deviation is available, the sample size is 75 values of x is taken. We have to find the probability that the sample mean is greater than 5, okay? Sample mean is greater than 5. So always remember, first try to write down the information. X is a random variable, which means that X is not normal distribution. Okay, students, X is a random variable, which is not a normal distribution. The mean is given, that is, sir, 4.9. And the standard deviation is given, that is, sir, 2.21. Similarly, sir, we have been given the sample size. Sir, sample size is 75. So we have been given sample size as 75. And we have to find the probability that the sample mean, that is x bar, so we have to find the probability sample mean x bar is greater than 5, okay? So probability of x bar is greater than 5. So what is the first thing, students, you need to check? Because, sir, the sample size is large, okay? Follow carefully, students. Sir, the sample size is large, it is greater than 30, so I can apply central limit theorem, because I have already available the mean and variance. The mean and variance are available to me, because we can find out mean and variance here. So it means you can first have to mention here that the central limit theorem will come in. Central limit theorem exists. Central limit theorem can be used, okay? So we can say that central limit theorem can be used here. Central limit theorem is applied, and x, because x is not normal distribution, x is not normal distribution, but x bar can follow normal distribution, sir. So it will be, sir, x bar following a normal distribution, in which we'll write down the mean, that is 4.9, and the variance, that is 2.21 square divided by 75, okay? So this will be 1 mark for writing this, students. It's a 3 mark question, okay? So it's not much, there is not too many marks for this. So we need to be careful. while you are solving this. You need to be careful while you, so x bars follow normal distribution, and then you just have to simply apply the formula that we do in normal distribution, the normal distribution, the statistics S1 chapter students. So let's do that, apply that as well, okay? So we know that we have to find the z value will be 5 minus 4.9, or let me write down the formula as well. It is the x bar value minus the mean divided by standard deviation. So it will be square standard variance square divided by n into the square root. Okay, so we have to do the square root here. So it will be, sir, the z value will be 5 minus 4.9. Students, follow carefully. The z value will be 5 minus 4.9. And in the denominator, it will be 2.21 square divided by 75 to the power of whole square. Okay, so eventually you will get the z value, students. The z value, let's put the use of calculator here now. 5 minus 4.9 divided by square root of 2.21 square into divided by 75. So I am getting 0.39186. So let me add on to three decimal places the z value, sir. The z value is 0.392, students. Let's revise the concept of normal distribution as well by making the diagram. That, sir, we have the diagram here, students. Follow very carefully. And this is the mean. That is the mean is, sir, this is basically the mean. That is 4.9, the basic mean. And you have to find the probability for 5. So 5 will be similarly greater than 5 you have to find. So basically you are looking for the area. Follow carefully, students. You are looking for the greater area, that x bar value is greater than 5. So how can you find it? So what you need is basically normal distribution concept, students. Probability of z is greater than 0.392 is what is the requirement here. You can't find it directly. Why, students? These are, now it's all about central limit theorem finishes, S2 finishes. It's all about statistics 1, basic concepts of normal distribution. You must know how to solve the z value bar, okay? So we have got 0.392 as z value, and the z probability of z is greater than 0.392 is we have to find. As always, we cannot find in the table the greater than side value, so we'll have to go for the left hand side, that it will be 1 minus the probability of z is less than 0.392. That will give us the answer, students. So let's try to quickly get this. What will be the z value? The probability for 0.392 will be 0.3 here, sir, 9 here, and then add 2 in it, so it will be 0.6517 plus 0.007. So I'm getting it as 0.6524, okay, students? So this is the value coming, 0.6517 plus 7. So it is coming 0.6524. So 1 minus 0.6524 will eventually give me the final answer. That is getting, students, 0.3476. So I can round off to 0.348. Three significant figures, you can round off this answer, or three decimal places, you can say as well in this case. This is concept done, and summary and revision done for concept number 2. Just remember, if the question is already in normal distribution, then the central limit theorem will not come. But if the question, the sample size is large and central limit theorem can come to make it normal distribution, we will apply that, okay? So it's a very important concept. Any questions can be asked. So make sure to take help and revise further and practice more questions on central limit theorem. Thank you, students.